There you are, Delroy Leslie unbeaten in six professional fights in action against Jonathan Thaxton, the former Southern Area Light Waterweight champion. And I'm very glad to say with me in the commentary position here, one of Britain's finest, most exciting fighters, Dave Boy Green. Hi Dave, how are you doing?
Hello, very good, thank you.
So here we are then, the former champion. The former champion coming to the ring. Delroy Leslie with the tiger skin trunks on. So over to Mike Goodall. Well, I don't honestly know if we're ready yet. And the problem we've actually got at the moment is that we're lacking a referee, and here he is, Ian John Lewis. He's just about to get into the ring. Here he comes. And of course, we can't start a match without a referee.
Adjust your mic. I want to sort of just around here a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to an evening of championship boxing from Bethnal Green. Your call on behalf of your promoters this evening, National Promotions. We welcome viewers throughout Europe on Eurosport, and in particular our viewers in southern Spain. Welcome. Our officials this evening are all appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control. The first contest in the ring this evening is a light welterweight contest over 6 3-minute rounds. Introducing firstly in the blue corner, wearing the solid black trunks and coming from Norwich, the former Southern Area champion, will you please welcome Jonathan Thaxton. And across the ring in the red corner, wearing the leopard skin trunks and coming from Carl Shorten, Delroy Leslie. And today's weigh-in, Thaxton scale, 10 stone exactly, Leslie 10 stone 2 pounds. Your officials for this contest, the timekeeper, Mr. Ray Rice, the referee, Mr. Ian John Lewis.
Right, let's start again then. Good evening once again to York Hall live here on Eurosport. And our first contest there, facing us on the left-hand side, Delroy Leslie unbeaten in six against Jonathan Thaxton, the former Southern Area champion. And once again, just to introduce with me, Dave Boy Green, the former British and European light welder and welterweight champion, and of course fought twice for the world championship. More about that later. David, Thaxton really from your neck of the woods, isn't he? Norwich man?
Near Norwich, yes. Yeah, he's a good fighter. We should see a good fight here, I think.
Yeah, I think so too. Six rounds, one is scheduled for. So here we are then. The very hard punching Jonathan Thaxton against the tall, rangy Delroy Leslie. And, well, a couple there from the blind side by Leslie. And, of course, the one fight that sticks in my memory, Dave, would be when John, albeit lost his area championship to Keith Marner in an absolute cracker. Won the vacant championship, beating Bob Williams from my neck of the woods in Watford. I lost it in his first defence, but still a very live wire, John Thaxton, and has a good future. And as anticipated, Thaxton going forward here in the first early stages. And John Thaxton fighting southpaw, right hand forward.
I've seen Thaxton, you know, two or three times before. He seems to me he's a southpaw and he's orthodox. He fights in both ways. You know.
Very useful, isn't it?
Yeah, he is. Very good.
Well, of course, Leslie, fresh off a very, very good win against one of Thaxton's stable mates, one Sean Cogan, who's a good fighter. And that was a fast start by Leslie Court Cogan.
He's got very, very long arms for his weight, isn't he?
Yes, very range, isn't he? And a nice right there, catching Thaxton in the mouth. And another one. Good shot. Oh, and a big left hook back from Thaxton there. So John Thaxton hurt there by a long right hand from Leslie. He comes from Carl Shorten in Surrey.
I would have thought the tactics was to get inside, get closer to him, because, you know, standing back, the fellow's very long arms.
Absolutely. But I think John possibly just regrouping, standing back to regroup, because he got pretty well tagged, Dave.
He did, yeah.
So the better start then to this round coming from Thaxton, but looks like Leslie's going to put in the finish now. Amazing what just a couple of good punches can do.
He's certainly missing a few shots, so Thaxton. He's moving about a lot.
Yes, he's quite a cagey fighter. Of course, coming from the Brendan Ingle gym, that's exactly what you expect, isn't it? A nice left uppercut there from Thaxton. That one hurt. That one really did hurt. And Leslie is in trouble now. And Thaxton piling on the punches there. Well, I'm sure we'll see that again in the replay. That was a very odd piece of behaviour by Leslie. And caught again. Well, a good start and a good finish.
What a good start. Tremendous.
Right, I think we're going to get that again, because that was well worth seeing. And a left uppercut from John Thaxton, and really Leslie just kind of... It was awful, wasn't it, his behaviour? Here we are. A long right hand, I think we'll see here from Leslie in the replay. Oh, cracking shot. And Dave, I think John took that one very well, didn't he?
Yeah.
And that incident just at the end of the round there was a left uppercut, as I say. This might
was
be
a very, very interesting round, really, wasn't it?
It was.
It's a good shot.
What, left uppercut, right hook there, and Leslie just kind of backed off, didn't he? He was hurt, and Thaxton just... Well, if he'd have realised sooner...
I'm quite impressed with Thaxton. He comes straight back in there and getting the man while he's halfway there, you know?
Yes. So it's a round two, then, David, this six-rounder. And both men, I think, it's fair to say, have tasted the power of each other in the opening round. Now Thaxton, all coming out left hand forward this time, Dave, as you suggested, and that time cracking two lovely rights in.
I think, you know, what we see in the first round, and Darryl has got something to think about now, you know, he's
absolutely
taking his time.
And another cup on the blind side there by Leslie, and referee Ian John Lewis just warning him for that. Of course, on occasion, John Thaxton reminds you a wee bit of your own tearaway style in the late 70s. Yeah. Do you see a bit of yourself in him?
Oh, yes, definitely, yeah. I mean, the fella just keeps coming forward and keeps throwing the punches.
And, of course, that's what we all love to see, isn't it?
Well, that's what it's all about at the end of the day, isn't it? Giving value for money.
Yeah, I think, though, without trying to sound rude, I think he's a bit tidier than you were, isn't he?
Sorry?
A bit tidier than you were.
Yeah. Oh, a lot more tidier than me.
But when he's in full swing, it's pretty good to watch. And of course, only a few good boxing times ever got the better of you, we know that. But you were kind of always in their face, weren't you? And that's really what Thaxton needs to do here, isn't it?
He's got to be on him all the time. Yeah, I don't think Thaxton doing himself any favours, just waiting and holding back. He's got to be in there.
Yes, I agree with you, Dave. No. Needs to keep this man under pressure.
But looking at the two of them, I think they both got resemblance myself. I mean, he's got the tiger skin shorts.
And that's about where the similarity ends, isn't it?
this is really what you come to see. I mean, this is a great little small hall fight, isn't it?
Yeah, and of course it can still go either way, can't it?
Yeah, it can at the moment.
Say that John Thaxton is winning this second round, though?
I think he just won the second round, yeah, definitely.
So there you are, we're looking at Delroy Leslie's corner, and outside the ropes there, some of you may remember, the former British and European super middleweight champion, James Cook. What a good little fighter he was in his time,
so I can say little.
There you are, a bit of replay then from the end of round two. And we think Thaxton just nicked that one, but certainly took the opener. This is round three then. So tactically, Dave, you've suggested that really Thaxton needs to stay right on top of it. Oh, down he goes. But that was a very awkward right hand, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. He's got to keep on him all the time.
Well, he's up at six, and this is where Leslie's going to be dangerous. He's still not exactly right. And Thaxton now ripping in the punches. And it's the kind of counter that Leslie can get through with here that can undo all those good plans by Thaxton. But once again, John Thaxton ripping in the punches.
In again.
He's a game fighter, isn't he, Delroy?
Certainly is.
And again, getting driven across the ring now. Well, things auguring well for the former Southern Area champion at this stage. He's in control and he's hurt Leslie. Leslie not quite over it yet.
See, this is where I think Thaxton's doing wrong. He should be on him more and more now. He's giving him time to get back into the game.
Anyway, I think it's also fair to say, Dave, that in your day, it was really fitness and attitude and determination rather than finesse that got the success you had. And I'm not too sure that John possesses that level of fitness. I don't think he can fight for three hard minutes now. Not round after round, you know.
I don't think he can keep it going too long. He just throws six, eight shots and he slows all of it. You've got to keep it going. He certainly looks a strong boy.
Yes. Oh, and a nice uppercut there from Leslie. Well, the Leslie fans now starting to shout. He's got a bit of a lump though around the right eye, and you can see also his lips are swollen. Well, John Thaxton now just skimming the perimeter, staying out of harm's way, and he's done plenty enough in this round to win it, David. The knockdown, of course, at the beginning.
Yeah, but I mean, I just think, like you say, perhaps his fitness is not quite up to standard because he should have been on him, and I think he should have got him out before now.
Yeah, but that said, I mean, when he did defend his championship against Keith Marner, it was an absolute tear-up from bell one.
Yeah.
And it was a brilliant performance. So, good round then again, I think, for John Thaxton. Of course, the knockdown helping his cause. I think you'll see that again. And there's Brendan Eagle, the guru of Sheffield, in the corner. And I think that here we are. This is the knockdown. It was a very awkward right hand that landed. About on the ear, I think. We'll get this pretty slowly, I think. Here we are. Boom. Yes, it was so on the ear, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. On the top.
And we might, here we are, there's another angle then to catch that knockdown. Boom. Yes, it was a very awkward. Yeah. That's the kind of punch that hurts your thumb, Dave, isn't it?
Absolutely right, yeah. I broke both of my thumbs doing that.
Absolutely. Haven't we all? So in the halfway stage, then, and John Thaxton, well, I suppose you could have made a case for giving Leslie a share of one of the rounds, but so far we've got Thaxton winning the first three. Oh, what a lovely shot there.
Well, that was a very good shot.
This might all be academic at the end of the day, the point score, because John Thaxton's just scored his second knockdown. This time with a lovely left hook and a nice right there as well, and Leslie forced to hang on.
Yeah, perhaps you got up a bit too quick there.
Once again, Thaxton imposing himself, but once again, Leslie counters.
Waiting again, you see, he's got to be in there again.
Well, it's quite a mature performance, Dave, from Thaxton, don't you think?
Oh, so, yeah, I mean,
he's a youngster.
Yeah, he's a good fighter. But I just think he needs to keep that pressure on a bit longer.
Certainly. Still, there's always that possibility that Leslie could find a very smart right hand and change the whole complexion of this fight.
Well, I think both of them, they're very good punchers, and I think anyone who hits them could change the game completely.
Absolutely. And, of course, the two knockdowns so far in favour of the Norwich fighter, John Thaxton. And such a gift. You had a fight left or right hand forward, Dave.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good asset, that one is. I understand, though, before he took up Western-style boxing, he was a kickboxer.
Certainly was, and a good one.
Yeah.
Yes, he was a British champion. But, of course, not everyone makes the transition successfully, do they, from kickboxing to boxing. But he's one that has. Once again, there, Thaxton connecting.
I think that's perhaps where he gets it, where he can go southpaw or orthodox, both way, both feet, you know.
I think you're probably right, David, yes. Looks at this stage like Thaxton knows he's got a pretty healthy lead and he doesn't want to do anything foolish. Consequently, not really engaging Delroy Leslie at this stage, is he, Dave?
He's not at all, no. I just think you take a few chances, stand him back a bit. He should be in there with him.
Right, I think we're going to get a replay of that earlier knockdown. Here we are. Boom, look at that lovely, lovely punch from John Thaxton. Leapt in from about 10 feet away. Crunch on the chin and the head spun. Here we are, another angle. This is a reverse angle. This would be a good one. Watch this. Watch his head go. And watch how far Thaxton leaps. Bang. Cracking shot, Dave.
Yeah, tremendous shot.
Yes, it was. Lovely, lovely punch. So, 4-0 then, in favour of young John Thaxton. So this then is the penultimate round, round 5 of this scheduled 6 in the light welterweight division. And in the black trunks, John Thaxton won the first 4. And the tiger skin shorted Delroy Leslie. Nice, rangy boxer with a very hard right hand, but unfortunately, Thaxton really just had too much power for him.
I think Thaxton is going to keep pushing him back because he seems very, very fit. He still keeps coming.
Yeah, Leslie, of course, protecting an unbeaten record. Looks like he's about to be burst, but he's very proud of that record and will fiercely fight until the final bell. Did you box at York Hall, Dave, as a pro?
Never boxed as a pro.
Did you?
I did as an amateur, but not as a pro.
Again, nice right from Thaxton. Oh, and Thaxton got a cut on the right cheek
there.
Yeah,
as you can see now, Delroy's getting in the charge a little bit there. He's in front.
It's not in a dangerous place, I'm glad to say, but there's no such thing as a good cut, is there?
No, not at all. But it's still going to be a bother to him. He's still going to worry about it.
Yep.
Oh, that's a good shot. It's a good right hand there by Delroy.
Been the best round so far for Leslie. Oh, and a clash of heads there. Oh, that was a bad clash. Again, some nice defensive footwork there. Good shot.
So he's going to get inside. Get inside, that's the best chance.
And that's that was half a push.
Yeah. That wasn't really a punch.
Well, John Thaxton really giving this round away, Dave, isn't he?
Well, I think so. You know, I keep saying he's got to keep in close. He's sending back, dancing around.
Oh,
he's
getting caught. Good shot, Dave.
Yeah, he's better going forward.
And Leslie, very, very game. Because I do know how hard Thaxton hits. Not that he's ever hit me, I'm glad to say, but...
did you box him as well?
No way. Now, our VT boys are trying to locate where John Thaxton got cut. It may well have been a right hand. No, it's cut already there, unfortunately. Well, it was just before then, because at least it isn't bleeding. I think Terry Toole, our matchmaker, has done a pretty good job bringing these two little firecrackers together tonight.
Well, I think it's going to be a very interesting last round.
Yes, Terry Toole is going to be following himself now.
So, yeah.
And he knows, surely, he needs a knockout to win. Oh, and a good right again. Good right again there from Leslie. But of course, really, this is exactly what Leslie needed to do earlier, wasn't it, Dave?
Just absolutely
to
right,
try
yeah.
and keep it rangy, keep it long.
Keep him away, but you know.
But John has just been on top of him.
He's been on him all the time.
Well, that's the third time that he's picked up a warning for blindside punching. Of course, Delroy Leslie is the homeboy fighter. And it looks like they're going to be slightly disappointed here tonight.
I think they are, yes. I think if he goes the distance, I think Faxon's got it.
this. He's made such a powerful start, didn't he? And he leveled at that stick, really.
No, he's doing very well. This is nice as well. Faxon's looking for him now. This is what he should have been doing every time. So I think he wouldn't have been kind enough to have kept.
Quite possibly, yes. And John Lewis there having a go at Leslie. And Mickey Duff rearing up in his ringside seat. I think he senses his man.
I think Mickey knows that perhaps this will be the first loss for his fighter.
Yeah.
If he doesn't do something
special.
Which
is never, of course, a pleasant experience, but one always you can learn from.
Absolutely right. Yes, it could perhaps do him some good in the long run.
Yeah. Did you ever learn from your losses, David? There wasn't many.
No, I lost to Callum in my first fight, was in the 25th fight.
So a bit too late to learn, really, by then.
Yeah, he was, yes.
More of that later, anyway. Yeah. Yes, of course, you fought Ray Leonard and Carlos Palomino for the World Welterweight Championship, which, as I say, we'll talk about later. This is a pretty level round, David. Yeah,
there's not much in this round now. I think I think Darwin's perhaps got the last round.
Quite possibly, yeah. So, approaching the final 10 seconds then, I'll see. Yep, he's gone for Paxton.
Yeah. Yes, I thought he had.
Well, there's no surprise there, really, is there, Dave?
No.
He's got it, in fact, 59-58 in favour of John Paxton. 4-2. So there's the winner, then, John Paxton. That's his 8th win in 9 starts. And the first loss, I'm afraid, for Delroy Leslie in 7 outings. But showing plenty of promise there, Leslie. Well, he's up against a fighter, I think, who's got a pretty good future in the game, John Paxton. So here we go then for the decision. So we had him winning by 2 rounds.
I had it 59-58, so
fair enough. Well, that'll go on again, I should imagine.
Yeah, that'll be a good return.
I think so, David. I'd like to see a championship at stake the next time these two guys meet, because they're too good, aren't they?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah. Anyway, we're going to take a short break in a few moments.